Can I just say real talk?
Yeah.
I fucking really wish we had got Erica on here.
Well, we
that
could,
shit
like,
sucks, bro.
It was going to happen, but he just fucking was going crazy, and I was just like.
But we
really does suck, doesn't it?
We wanted to have him on here. That was, he was one of the guests
that
we
had. You know the reason, he didn't come on was because when I asked him to come out, he just got arrested, and he was like, I can't, my passport.
Yeah, but shit was a bit crazy for him around the time in general.
Mm.
It was like, that's a bit full on.
I wanted to meet him so bad, dude. That's why I fucked me up, because I wanted to meet him first.
That's what I was saying before. He was one of your fucking idols, surely.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, Erica, I have this little page of like my fucking life, and the Etika is definitely like a big chunk of it where it's like in Etika's name type beat.
Did that fuck you up?
For a while, yeah. Like, it didn't fuck me. I mean, that's why I made a Keemstar video. I don't like fuck with the drama, but I just had to. Like, after Etika's death, I was like, oh, I gotta head in.
I think that was the first like celebrity that had passed away that is more of like an impact on my life or people
like,
around me than anyone else. Like, because a lot of the time celebrities die or whatever. And people always act super emotional. I'm like, you don't know that fucking person.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't really know the guy, but that affected me more than...
Erica had authenticity. That's why people fucking love him so much, because he was so real. Even before and mental illness, he was so fucking real. And such a motivation, because he was like, he was so smart. You could tell he's so smart. He's such a smart fucking person. And he would have gone far. Pretty damn fucking far. He knew what he was doing, man.
And we had a lot of I had a lot of interactions with messaging and stuff like that. And it just feels it, like, you know, like you said, like when someone passed away, like when other YouTubers like Chrissy and Grimmy and all that passed away, everyone's like, so I'm like, I never really knew her. I knew of her. That, it kind of sucks. But it feels weird because it was like, I had genuine conversations with the guy. I had interactions with him. I can't imagine how many other people did. So I'm not saying I was special or anything, but it was like,
that was more,
it was really
that was
up
more close to home.
Because
we
messaged each other. Like, we've had interactions with this guy. He's spoken about us. We've both inspired each other. I've looked into him. I've watched his dreams. He's inspired me. And it feels weird knowing that this person is no longer with us, because you've lived your whole life through looking at them through a screen, and they'll always be on your screens. There'll always be videos of Etika, but knowing there'll be no more new videos of Etika is like the part where you're like, oh, damn, this actually has happened.
It
took ages for a lot of people to think like, well, he's actually gone.
Yeah, it's very surreal.
It didn't matter what the fuck he posted. You could just tell, like, the genuineness of him as a person, as a black man especially, it attracted everyone. And he liked people, too. Like, to this day, I'm still friends, super close friends with people. Like, the first time I ever left my city, first time I ever been in the U.S., I went to go meet guys who were friends with Etika. It was right after he died. And these are guys
who didn't
give
a fuck about sub count and shit like
that. Oh, yeah.
That.
These guys were so small, had no subs, nothing, but he would like love them. You know what I mean?
Same people. Same with you. I had interactions with people he knew. I had interactions with him and Captain Nintendo dude and all those people. And I'd spoken to them just DMs. You know, you live in other countries, you can't go see them, but messaging them, Skyping them, Discording is as good as a blind person meeting someone, you know? And you had all these interactions with people and you're like, this guy doesn't give a fuck about subs. He doesn't give a fuck. He's a genuine guy. Yeah, he's a bit fucking nuts, but who isn't, you know? And he was just an all right, like all round fucking genuine guy. And you knew anything he said, he'd never lie. He was always genuine about who he was and how he spoke to people and how he interacted with people.
He combined his smarts with YouTube and being genuine. Like, he knew that who he was. But he lost so much when he died. So much. We lost so much. But still, even after his death, he provided so much.
He left so much behind.
He left so much behind, but he gives.
He wanted to fucking leave a message as well about like fucking treating your mental health. Correctly,
yeah.
Especially with doing social media and YouTube and stuff like that.
Had he lived, he would have done great things. But even after his death, he's still doing great things. And before his death, you could tell like he knew from the beginning that he was going to be. Because like all legends start somewhere. That's something that's in my Twitter bio. That's originally from Etika.
And when he passed away, whether or not his videos were getting 100K views or a million views, you know that if he was ever gone or if he ever stopped, everything that he had done would always be looked back upon and people that are inspired by him. And even if at the time he wasn't doing as good as he used to be, he still left behind some sort of legacy that people can look at and be like, that's who I want to be. That's how I want to be.
And that His shit was so fucking big.
Yeah, you
all
saw
his
it everywhere.
Clips and shit on Twitter were just like fucking
if he didn't get recognition for like clips and stuff like that, no one would know the name of the person, but his clips were everywhere. It was everywhere.
It's like brand awareness and like, not specifically to whatever, but like, his stuff would spread on whoever's account or wherever it was posted, like just because it was funny in general, rather than being from a content creator's channel. Or
What a fucking legend, bro. Everyone's got to love AK. He was such a good fucking person.
He was a, he wanted everyone to be real, bro.
He was Let's keep it real.
Can you say it, bro? Can
real
you say
nigga.
It?
Real nigga. Absolute fucking legend, real nigga. Realest nigga I fucking know.
To Etika.
Realest fucking nigga.
To Etika.
I got no. Oi, can I get a drink? Can you pour a drink for that?
I'm absolutely fucked.
I don't want to cheers him an empty glass, bro.
Wait, give one more shot for Max, man, to Etika. Joy-Con boys. I mean, I play with a pro controller, but Joy-Con boys for life, man.